Help us drink, Lord, from your hand this morning. Help us drink. Oh, you said if you knew who sat before you, you would ask for a drink. And if you drank from his hand, you would never drink again. You would never be thirsty again. And Lord, today I'm declaring I want to drink from your hand. I want to drink, Lord, from your hand. I want to drink from your heart. I want to drink, Lord, from your heart this morning.
Oh, Jericho, they did seven trumpet blasts.
A good ministry moment.
Hallelujah.
You're better, Lord.
Glory. Glory. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Filling you.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Of the Lamb that was slain. I want to drink from the heart of our blessed Messiah.
Times of refresh. Hey, give me a little something.
Yeah.
Lead that up. It's hard to preach while somebody else is preaching.
Only you have the words of life.
You know, the Bible talks about order in the church. And order in the church looks like two people prophesying at the same time.
That's true.
That's God's order versus man's order. Don't believe me? Look it up in the Bible.
It's true.
The word of God says, let two prophesy at the same time, let a third prophet listen. Let a third prophet weigh the word. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Glory.
Hallelujah.
But I do believe when someone's preaching, unless the words offer something, God's not going to interrupt himself. I believe that talks about personal words of prophecy, like if there's time during a service. You know, you don't hear a lot of talk like that in regular services. You don't, hey, has anybody got a word? How often? What church do y'all go to where they say, hey, does anybody have a word out there? Raise your hands if you go to that type of church, besides here.
No.
Nobody. Does anybody else have a word, or is it just the pastor being a rock star?
Come on.
You know, the Holy Spirit told me about 3 or 4 years ago, I'm through with rock star preachers.
Come on.
There's people that would tell me that's not the Lord. God, look in the Bible and tell me where the same preacher is getting up and preaching every single Sunday or day. Show me one scripture, just one, that says the man of God will preach the same man of God will preach every single week. Show me one scripture. Are we all the body of Christ? And one of us is the eye, one of us is the tongue, one of us is the inward parts that are the most important, is what my Bible says.
Come on.
You know, it's the intercessors a lot of times that are overlooked. I hear the Lord saying, not in my eyes.
Hallelujah.
Not in my eyes, says the Lord. The intercessors are not overlooked in the kingdom of God.
Amen.
The ones that are trying to be seen will be laid low. The ones where it's all about them and their kingdom, and they're from trying to tap along the kingdom of God, trying to sprinkle some Jesus on whatever they're doing. They're doing their own movements.
Hallelujah, Lord.
And they're saying it's the Lord.
Yeah, amen.
They're having a revival service where it's just a few praise songs. I want real revival. You can't have real revival without real repentance.
Hallelujah.
Real repentance.
Hallelujah.
Real repentance. You know what real repentance is? It's picking up your cross, dying to yourself.
Hallelujah.
And your wants and your ways, and following after the only one who knows the way, because he is the way. I just felt the Holy Spirit say, pray this, so we're going to pray this. Everybody raise your hands.
No problem.
Father God, I release.
Father God, I release.
An impartation.
Of dreams.
Visions. Over everyone gathered here. In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
The Lord showed me this before, but I see little. If I didn't know better, it almost looks like really thin snow, but it's manna from heaven. I see manna from heaven being released. That's fresh words, fresh revelation. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Somebody praise the Lord.
Glory. Hallelujah.
You know, we need revelation. But let me tell you, the application of the revelation is the wisdom aspect of it.
Hallelujah.
We need wisdom in revelation.
Yes, amen.
That's where we get the war out of War Eagles. It's wisdom and revelation. That's how we do warfare. That's how we do battle. Without wisdom and revelation, without a fresh word from heaven, we need the Logos. We need the Logos, but we need a Rhema word. We need a Now word. We need both. We can't have the Rhema without the Logos. You need the Word of God as our firm foundation to build upon the house, the rock. Without the Word, you're on sinking sand. There's a lot of churches out there that are charismatic that are built on sinking sand, and they're going to sink.
Hallelujah.
They're going to sink quick in this season. Quicksand. They're under quicksand because their kingdoms are going under. Let me tell you, the kingdoms of man aren't just going to be tried and tested. They're going to burn. They're going to fall.
Come on.
Let me tell you, my God's kingdom lasts forever and ever. The kingdom of the Lord lasts forever and ever, for every age and all ages to come thereafter.
Amen.
He's an eternal God. When we're aligned with Him, when we have the Holy Spirit, we're being led by the Holy Spirit, then the kingdom of God is in us. And through us, that's how we witness. Because we can't do anything without Him.
Come on.
Hallelujah.
But let me tell you, when we park it on just the Logos and we miss the Rhema, we miss the move of the Holy Spirit, it's nothing but religion. You can't have the Word without the Holy Spirit. Jesus said, worshippers of me will be worshippers in spirit and in truth. You can't have truth without the Word of God. You can't have spirit without the Holy Spirit.
Hallelujah.
Some people are going after some lowercase spirits, some lowercase S spirits, and they're calling it God. And let me tell you, they're about to crash and burn. A lot of psychics out there claiming to be prophets.
Hallelujah.
They're not even trying to hide it anymore. It's the height of hubris. It's arrogance. You know, you want to know something funny? We've been called that here, and they don't even know. They don't even know the character. They don't even know. You know what the Lord says when I pray about whenever someone calls me a false prophet or this is a cult or whatever? I pray about it, and you know what the Lord tells me? Do you know what the Lord tells me? They called me Beelzebub.
Amen.
They called him the master full of demons. Yeah. What makes you think when you're walking this thing for real they won't say the same exact thing about you? What makes you think they won't attack your character? But it will be baseless when you're walking armored up. Somebody say armored up.
Armored up.
I need my armor on.
Got armor on.
You don't put it on every day. You know why? Because you're never supposed to take it off. I don't have to get up and say, I'm putting on the helmet of salvation. I'm walking in the Lord Jesus. Why? Because he's my friend. He knows me.
Amen.
But I also serve him. He's my master. But when you serve him for long enough, you know what he says? Now you're my friend.
Hallelujah.
Obedience is different the higher up you go. Obedience is different the higher up you go. Because sometimes we come in the crossroads and God goes, what do you want to do?
Yeah, come on, that's right.
The higher up you go, God starts giving you options.
Yeah.
And you know, Moses had options. And you know what Moses prayed? God, if you're not going first, I don't want to go there.
Amen.
That's wisdom. There's a more ideal way to walk. Even when God gives you options, there's the permissive will, and then there's the perfect will.
Yes,
I don't know about y'all, but I want to be in the perfect will of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
But every once in a while, if I'm going to be honest, I'm walking in the permissive will, as we all are.
Amen.
Nobody walked this thing 100% except for the Lord. But that's not our excuse to not strive to get closer to him. And there's no striving as far as works in the Lord, but our relationship requires work. A relationship requires work. Some people say, the Lord's called me to rest. Okay, but the Lord hadn't called you to rest for a year without working and laboring. Sometimes the Lord tells you to rest, but sometimes he says, go out there and do some stuff for me. Do some stuff with me, because he's there. We're co-laboring with him. It's a co-mission, co-partnership, co-laboring. He's with us.
Hallelujah.
We're supposed
to communion
with him. How can you have co without it? It's more than just fellowship. Fellowship can be surface level a lot of times.
Yeah.
It's a relationship. It's intimacy with the Father.
Yes, amen.
How can we be that way? How can we be aware of his presence? He's always there.
Acknowledge me. Acknowledge his presence.
That means when we tell even a half-truth and the Lord convicts us, we got to make it right.
Amen.
Haven't done that in a long time. Praise the Lord. And it's not through my works that I'm saved. It's through him. But as we're growing and we're maturing and submitting to the process, he brings us up higher. It's through humility we walk, and through humility we're raised higher. And then you know what happens when we're raised higher? He starts raising us up higher. It's true, we go lower. But he starts raising us up higher because there's spiritual rankings. There are rankings in the spirit. And some people won't believe this. They'll think this is an arrogant statement, but it's not. It's just imparting revelation. There's rankings in the spirit. This is going to sound like heresy. Y'all ready for something deep? You want to hear something deep? You know, Jesus, he had to get baptized.
But he did.
He got baptized.
Hallelujah.
By John the Baptist. John said, it blew his mind. You're supposed to baptize me. He said, no, you're supposed to baptize me.
Do it in order. Hallelujah.
And then when Jesus did the 40-day fast, there's something about fasting that coincides with your ranking. The Lord spoke to me several years ago. He said, when you complete the 7-day fast, your rank's going to go up. It took me like 7 tries, water only. I'm not telling anybody to do a 40-day fast unless the Lord tells you to. But let me tell you, a lot of generals go through that 40-day fast. My apostle, my pastor, he went through the 40-day fast. He almost died. And then he did die later, and he saw Jesus. Trying to get him back out here to preach again. It's going to be a good time.
Amen.
But you remember when Jesus went up on the Mount of Transfiguration? After he passed all the trials? Let's hear it. I mean, what happened then? His face shined with the glory of God as he was hanging out with the Father.
Hallelujah.
Jesus was showing us how to go up in spiritual rank at the same time. Somebody say glorification.
Glorification.
How often do you hear glorification talked about
there.
In church? How often? You hear sanctification a lot. How do you hear glorification?
Glory.
You know that word's in the Bible.
Glory.
That word's in the Bible.
Amen.
Glorification is a deeper level than sanctification. It means you're becoming more like Jesus.
Amen.
And Jesus was becoming more like the Father.
Amen.
You know what happened with Moses when he hung out with the Father?
Face shone.
His face shone. And he went and just shone off. Huh? Bad pun. He had to put a veil on his face.
Amen.
Because it made people upset. It pissed people off. The higher up you go in rank, You know how worldly people try to go up in rank? By tearing other people down.
Yeah.
Oh, you're false. Why do you say that? I don't like what you say. Prove what I say is not biblical. And then you can call me false. No, they can call you false all day, but it has no... It carries no weight. There's no substance to it. Why would someone call you false with a baseless accusation? Who else does that? Starts with a D. Or to the devil. Yeah, same thing. If their accusations are baseless, based on absolutely nothing, that's the same thing the devil does. But if you provide scriptures for what you're saying, backing it up with the foundation of truth, I'm not talking about twisting scripture.
Yeah.
That's also what the devil does.
Line upon line, precept upon precept.
Two people can prophesy at the same time.
Hallelujah.
1 Corinthians 14, I believe. Y'all pray in the spirit with me for a second. There's someone right here, right now, attacked with the feeling that I don't belong here. I don't belong here. If that's you, come up for prayer. I'm not saying you're feeling that. It's an attack.
Yeah, amen, amen.
Come up for prayer. You're invited.
Come.
If you'd like a deeper connection with God, come up with prayer.
Come
up for prayer.
Come. Courage, Lord God. Father, I ask you for courage, Lord God.
What will they think? Who cares? Who cares?
Oh,
Let me explain a deeper connection with God. A deeper connection with God is correlated by praying in the Spirit, being baptized in the Spirit. That's an overflow. That's how we do ministry. We can do greater works. If you like prayer, no one here is going to force you to do anything. But I would like to invite you up for prayer. There's also like some kind of heart pain going on. It's also an attack.
Cut them off.
Come up for prayer. I'd say some more stuff, but it would sound rude. So I'm just going to leave it open. If you'd like prayer for anything, come up. There's an anointing. I'm sensing there's a healing angel in the room. But there's an anointing for a baptism of fire in the room.
You like your fire lit. Hallelujah.
Come up. Come up. All who are hungry. If you're not hungry, stay seated. If you're not thirsty,
I want more.
Come on. Come on up, Danny. Y'all extend your hands, pray in the Spirit. All depression has to go in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. All depression go.
Now.
In the name of Jesus.
Jesus.
I'm hearing a reminder. Anointed.
Hallelujah.
Appointed. Son. Son.
Amen.
Lord, showing me this orange and yellow fire that's like, it's skinny and it's getting larger.
Hallelujah. I receive it with gladness.
The Lord is showing me like a measuring rod and a ruler. And I see like the faith is growing by inches.
Hallelujah. Deeper, Lord.
The Lord showed me there was a demonic imp on assignment to block this level of faith. And there's more. We bind the enemy in the name of Jesus. The Lord's showing me this waterfall, and you're just being bathed by like the foam at the bottom of the waterfall.
Hallelujah.
Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Lord.
receive it with gladness.
I'm hearing mighty man and warrior of joy. There's going to be more joy.
Hallelujah.
In the next 2 weeks, people are going to think you're insane. You're just going to start laughing. Hey, Tepat.
Amen. Bring it. I receive it with gladness, Lord God.
Religious people are going to be so super pissed.
More, Lord, it'd be okay,
keep it up.
Lord God.
Keep it up.
Hallelujah. Woo. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Receive it all with gladness.
I'm going to leave the altar open before we even start. This is a form of worship.
Hallelujah.
We're going to leave the altar open before we start praise.
Come.
Like prayer, speak healing. I see this like steel beam, like a girder, and it was attacking you. I don't know if there was a work-related injury or something that was happening, but Father God, we just speak healing over Zach's body right now in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. God, if it's an attack over his business, Father God, we come against it in the mighty name of Jesus. God, we release your warring angels right now in the spirit realm. Ho! Roko bonde batte. Roko bonde bandu. In the name of Jesus. Ho! Rebate titi ande kete atoko toko toko teke. I hear the Lord saying, you've been standing on a word of healing. And in the next 3 weeks, you're going to see progressive healing over your life. Oh, even now, even now. Oh! Oh! Jesus! Woo! There's a powerful angel just hovering over us. Oh! Oh, thank you, Lord. Thank you. We break off every demonic hindrance coming against this man of God in the name of Jesus. Oh! Oh! I hear the Lord saying, faithful one, no more running. No more running. No more running. There's a slower pace. There's going to be sound sleep and rest and rest, because you know how to work, but working out of the place of rest, God's got a, he's tipping, I see him like, what's that called, like those old fashioned weight scales, he's like tipping the scale to where it's like more balance. Oh, shukum barabaraya. Oh, Jesus. I just see the Lord smiling at you. He's beaming a smile at you. He's so pleased with you. There was even a time this week where you lost your temper, but the Lord says you straight repented for that. So, well done. Hallelujah. Bless you, bro. Woo!
Hallelujah.
Right?
Hallelujah.
Lord God. I'll take feel it, prayer. Lord. Feel the cup, Lord God.
Vash, go back to playing that YouTube thingy.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Whoa! Whoa! I need.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Wow. There's an impartation of power. I'm seeing these like skulls, like these three skulls, and I see them like in the Jesus just has them in his hands and crushes them. I hear word curses, demonic word curses. They're just being broken off your life. At the head. People, the Lord's saying, people that you thought were your headship in the past, he's breaking the stuff off of you, the word curses, the declarations and the proclamations that were made. And the Lord is breaking those, just completely shattering them. It's like they're ground to powder in one hand. Just simple clench, and then they're gone. Jesus. They only think for increase of authority.
Be filled in Jesus.
My Jesus. I see it like the old mantle is like a brown mantle being lifted off of you, and this like purple and gold mantle.
Glory be to God.
It was like the shepherd mantle, and now there's an impartation to join the royal line, and I hear festivities. There's going to be great jubilation. Because of your dedication amidst the attacks, you said, God, I'm in this. And the Lord is saying, yes. I just hear yes, like access granted, yes. I see there's a song, of course it's not the right song, but it's like purple rain. There's new wine just raining down in this place. There's new wine. I see the Lord. It's like he's being a servant right now, and he's handing out these like gold chalices, these goblets. And he says, drink of me. Drink of the pleasures of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And that's for everybody. It's raining in this room right now. It's for everyone. It's for everyone. It's for everyone. Just receive. Just receive. There's a couple people. I want you to raise your hands. And with nobody looking around, and just God, I want you, let's all pray this prayer. God, if this is you,
come meet a man who told me all I ever did.
Because there was a couple people that had that question in their mind. God, is this you?
Unlike any other.
God, is this you? All he needs is that little bit of faith. God, if this is you, I want it. All he wants is that little bit of faith. And then he'll cause that rain to overflow in your life.
Never thirst.
Still sensing heart issues, still sensing impartation of fire. Still sensing it. If you want more, now is the time. Normally, we don't pray before worship. I love getting into worship and praise. But this is what the Lord is directing me to do.
You're better, Lord, Jesus, than Instagram's following.
That you can
You're better,
that.
Lord, than the high of a good again. Ministry moment. You're better, Lord.
Thank you, Lord. Father God, we just thank you for touching and healing. Everybody, just point their hands. Dad, if you could come up here. So I'm hearing the Lord's giving you discerning of spirits, and it's not your heart. You're actually sensing the same thing. So it's a type of discernment that the Lord is giving you. The Lord is giving you more discerning of spirits. And sometimes that manifests in ways that we don't like, because it'll be like aching in certain areas, arm hurts, leg hurts, whatever. And that's one of the ways God's going to show you how the people you're going to be praying for. Because to be a perfect evangelist, you have to be prophetic.
Hallelujah.
And it's not something that it's going to take a toll on your body, but God wants you to know that you have to receive it if you want it. If you don't want it, then He will not give it to you. Is that something that you're wanting more of the Lord?
Yes.
So, Father God, we thank You for the gift of discerning of spirits being stirred up
God.
In Brother Chad right now.
Hallelujah.
Father God, we thank You for touching Him. God, we thank You for healing flowing through His body now. But God, we thank You for showing Him through this, giving Him words for people. It's going to be the right thing, right at the right time.
Be strong, be courageous.
Thank You, Jesus. Thank You for His heart to take time out for people. Everywhere He goes. Thank You, Jesus. Thank You. Bless the word that He's bringing tonight. Thank You, Jesus. Thank You, Lord. I felt the heart thing go away. How you feeling? God, we come against spirits of anxiety.
Yes, Lord.
In the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah. Peace.
Oh, shut. Right? Can I pray with you? Thank You, Lord. Father God, we just thank You for the special anointing You have over her life. Chad, if you can put your hand on her shoulder. Whoa! Father God, we thank You for stirring up the gifts. I'm giving You more power for deliverance. There's an electricity flowing through. Oh, go shut the
head.
We come against all anxiety in the name of Jesus. The spirit of fear of man, we command to go now in the name of Jesus. We bind up everything that the oof. The Lord saying, you're such a good supporter and helpmate, but you forget to take care of yourself sometimes. Oh, shokaraba. Repati rebaturaba. Oh! You need to start, you do it sometimes, but you need to start communicating better with your husband about when you're being attacked, because you don't want to cause greater anxiety sometimes, but you've been getting attacked. To bear burdens together. attack of the enemy to be silenced in the name of Jesus. We bind up the enemy.
Yes.
God, we thank you for your warring angels going forth on their behalf, for their family. Oh. Oh, Sharabatarabayato. Bless her, Lord. Bless them, Lord.
Yes.
Bless this powerhouse couple.
Yes.
Oh, I'm ready for worship. Who's ready for worship?
Hallelujah!
Got one more person we're supposed to pray for, though, but he has to step out.
Amen. Amen.
Come on.
Amen.
Come on.
More faith, Lord. More faith, God.
There's more. Can I pray for you? Why didn't you respond? You knew the Lord was calling you. Oh, to. This anointing oil is a spirit of Elijah oil. There's nothing special about the oil. Smells really good. It's just a representation of the Holy Spirit. Raise your hands, brother.
Come near, Holy Spirit. Come near, precious presence of the Lord. Let the fragrance of heaven
be not troubled. Oh, I see a supernatural peace as the Lord speaks. Peace, be still. The waters of chaos turn to glass. Oh!
Let the fragrance of the Lord be about us. Fragrance of the Lord.
It's a bold word, but I hear the Lord saying, that one was to prepare you for the next one.
Be about us.
I have the perfect one for you.
Let the aroma of His presence hang on every garment.
When you meet her, you're just going
to
know.
The joy of the Lord flow like a river.
But the Lord just wants you to focus on Him right now, okay?
Let the presence of the Father, let the grace of the Holy Spirit, let the wine of joy from heaven flow freely. Let the power of the Spirit, purity of heaven, let the fire of the Father fall on me.
You haven't even told anybody, but the devil's been attacking you pretty bad. We come against that in the name of Jesus.
God,
in the name of Jesus.
Joy.
In the name of Jesus.
Oh, God,
you're never alone anyway. You got the Lord.
Baba. Jesus.
There's an angelic presence of fire, and I hear the Lord saying, I will impart fire in you. Well, you'll never question again. Speaking in tongues. Right now, Lord.
Let me know.
Even now, man. The Lord, I mean, I just see him like coursing through you just with powers, rivers of living water. But it's up to you to open your mouth. You don't have to sound like any of us. Just open your mouth and start to speak utterance.
Let me see your beauty. I'll go anywhere. As long as you go with me, I'll do anything. As long as you do with me, send me anywhere. Just send me with your presence.
Break it in the name of Jesus. Ho! You know what? The devil's forever alone. He might have lots of people that, but he's alone. He doesn't have the Lord. If you don't have the Lord, you're alone.
A song that I felt the Lord laying on my heart to sing with you. There's something special about the place of humility, and it's symbolized, and it's actually reality of being at his feet. His feet is the place we want to be, because the glory of his presence, the beauty of his presence, but our frail bodies can't handle it, and our humanity with all its flesh can't handle it. And so we find ourselves at the feet of the one who has eyes like fire, whose breath slays the wicked, and whose rod is in his hand to judge the nations with righteousness. And this song describes that process of being at his feet and worshiping him. And I want you all to come right now at his feet. And just, if you have to use your imagination, just use your imagination. But there's a reality to it that's more than just your imagination. It's real. He is here really, and you are worshiping at his feet. I wanna sit at your feet, drink from the cup in your hand, lay back against you and breathe, and feel your heartbeat. This love is so deep, it's more than I can stand. I'm melting in your arms, it's overwhelming. It's overwhelming. So now I want to sit. I want to sit at your feet, drink from the cup in your hand, lay back against you and breathe, and feel your heartbeat. And this love is so deep, it's more than I can stand. I'm melting in your peace, it's overwhelming. Let me see your beauty. Oh God. Oh God. Oh God. Oh God. Sing that, oh God. This love is It's more than I contend. I'm melting your arms. It's overwhelming. Let the weight of his presence, let it flood your soul. Let it flood your soul. Let it flood your senses as the weight of your love, as the weight of your glory is all around us. Can you feel it now? It's not about feelings, but sometimes his weight overwhelms us. Sometimes it's love. And I am lost in your love. I'm lost in your song. As you sing over us, I sing along. I am lost in your grace and the light of your face. Jesus, I'm lost in you. I'm lost in your love. I'm lost in your song. As you sing over me, oh, I sing along. I am lost in your grace and the light of your face. Jesus, I'm lost in you. We wanna sit lay back against you and breathe, feel your heartbeat, 'cause this love is so deep, it's more than I can stand. I melt in your arms, it's overwhelming. I wanna sit at your feet, drink from the cup in your hand, lay back against you and breathe, feel your heartbeat, 'cause this love is so deep, it's more than I can stand. I melt in your arms, it's overwhelming.
Yes.
Down at your feet, let your garment cover over us. Let your garment cover over us. Just hide our shame within the beauty of yourself. Expecting love for anything but love, we pour our love just to love you, Jesus. Just to love you, Jesus. Just to hear you say that you love us. Just to feel your arms around us. Oh. Your spirit break out, break our walls. love you need walls broken down. Spirit, break out. Heaven, come down. Spirit, break out. Break our walls down. Spirit, break out. As heaven comes down. Oh. Name is like on my lips, the Spirit like water to my soul. Your word is a lamp unto my feet. Jesus, I love you. I love you. Your name is like honey on my lips. Your spirit like water to my soul. Your word is a lamp unto my feet. Just say the name, just say the name of Jesus. Everlasting Lord, glorious one, Counselor wonderful, oh, all powerful King, glorious Savior, Prince of Peace. Wonderful Counselor.
It's important to do to just let's go. I feel like we need to kind of get back into unity. Let's sing that song. Can we sing that song?
Jesus.
Turn all your focus to the Lord.
Jesus. Risen.
Your name. deeper intimacy. Jesus.
Deeper.
Jesus.
Jesus.
Just speak his name.
Jesus.
It's not enough knowing about God. You gotta know. You gotta know him. You gotta know him. Even the demons know and tremble. You gotta know him. You gotta know him. You gotta know him. You can't just know about him. So many people, there's so many lost out there believing that they're Christians. There's so many. There's so many. This world needs a touch from the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And you know the Lord is desiring to use your hands and feet. He's desiring to send us forth. Go forth into the whole world.
Yeah,
it's not about me. It's not about Leo leading worship. It's about the kingdom of the living God.
Hallelujah.
There's a world that needs the gospel.
Hallelujah.
There's a world that needs Jesus.
Hallelujah.
It's not enough to just stop at salvation. We need to do the greater works that he's called us to do.
Glory. Glory.
You can only do it through intimacy.
Hallelujah.
You can't do it from a place of strange. You can't carry strange fire. You can only carry his fire.
Hallelujah.
I don't care how much
Hallelujah.
You can prophesy. If you don't know him, you have nothing. I don't care how great you can preach. If you don't know him, it's all for naught. I don't care how great you are with words. I don't care how sympathetic or empathetic you can be to someone's plight. If you don't know Jesus, if you're not pointing the way back to Jesus, those words are going
to
get burned up. Not in a good fight.
Do you know him? Hallelujah.
Are you, who are you doing what you do for?
Pray, God.
As for me and my house, we serve
Yahweh.
The Lord Yahweh.
Hallelujah.
He is the only way.
Hallelujah.
He is the only way.
Hallelujah.
There is no other truth
Hallelujah.
But Jesus.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Truth is the man, Jesus.
Yeah.
Truth is my God, Jesus.
Yeah.
Truth is.
Come on.
Without truth, you have nothing. Without truth, there is no love.
Come on.
Without love, there is no truth.
Amen.
There's no such thing as a white lie to spare someone's feelings. If you haven't learned grace yet, go ahead and step on their toes in truth. You're going to offend somebody telling them the truth. You're going to offend somebody. Somebody, if you're walking as a real Christian, the goal is not to offend, but truth offends. The goal is truth. The goal is Jesus. The goal is to run the race well. Glorification. How much did you love like Jesus?
Come
That's
going to
be the question in the end. How much did you love like Jesus?
Do you love him enough to tell
did you? Are you loving them as you love yourself? Do you even love yourself? Because it's false humility that says, I'm not worthy. Because if you are in him and he's in you, you are counted among the chosen. You are not forsaken. You are accepted, not rejected.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
If Christ Jesus dwells within you, if the Holy Spirit resides within you, you know love and you're known by love. You know truth and you're known by the truth. You know the way.
This is the way walking.
my God, in whom I place all my trust.
Hallelujah.
If my trust is in man, I would have given this thing up years ago. If my trust was in a religious spirit or a religious system or the kingdoms of Babylon and the earth, I would have given up.
I said, they're gonna burn. And the only thing that would remain is the kingdom.
My one, my only goal in this whole world is to hear, well done.
Come on.
I don't care if 50,000 ministers call me false prophet. I don't care, and I'm not in bitterness, but I'm aware because the Lord tells me things.
Come on.
He promised you. If you serve the master, he promised you you'd be rejected. He promised you you'd be persecuted.
Yeah.
He promised these things. If they called Jesus, this is his words, if they called the master Beelzebub, who are they going to call the servants?
He was doing good and they called him evil. Hallelujah.
Show me another sign. Show me another miracle. Show me another healing. Show me another prophecy. So they can nitpick you to death and criticize. It's a wicked generation that asks for a sign. What does that mean? It means he was a walking, talking sign. He was a walking, talking miracle and they couldn't see him.
Amen.
If you're seeing signs, wonders, and miracles, because those are going to follow true believers, if you're seeing them and still questioning them, it's not something wrong with the minister.
You said it's a wicked and perverse.
Perverse means twisted. They got it backwards. They called, you're the devil. He said, actually, y'all are the devil. Y'all are the children of the devil. Ministers.
Amen.
When they look at you and they accuse you, and if you're walking in the Holy Spirit, if you're armored up, they're looking in a mirror. I was told this week, you're hearing from the Holy Spirit sometimes, and you're hearing from familiar spirits sometimes. I was told that this week by a minister. You know, when I prayed about it, you know what the Lord told me? It's them. And then I checked with the council of elders. That person's been off for a while. I don't surround myself with yes men either.
There's a no woman.
I tell people things that I surround myself with people that tell me what I need to hear, not what I want to hear.
The truth.
The truth, the life. Let's praise the Lord some more. And then we got an awesome word tonight
brought
by Brother Chad. Y'all give it up for Brother Chad.
Yeah.
Woo! It's gonna be good.
Hallelujah.
The Lord's telling me there's somebody watching online that specifically needs to hear this word. So y'all continue to like and share the video. As soon as I said that, a bunch of likes just went. Y'all like and share the video. Let's get the word out there. If you need prayer, please type your prayer request in the chat. One more worship song. Hallelujah.
Amen. Glory.
So we're going to do one more worship song. And this is the song, it's from Jesus Culture.
Ooh,
you know, I hope we have a Jesus Culture here.
Yeah.
And that means that you and I put on Jesus Christ. Amen?
Amen.
That's scripture right there. So you can't argue with me. We put on Jesus Christ, which means you and I are Jesus in the flesh. What do you think it means to be called in his name? You said pray in his name. It means as his representative. Amen. Amen. So this last song is asking the Lord to let it rain. That is, when you and I put on the Lord Jesus Christ, it is the raining in our city. Amen. Rain, R-E-I-G-N, and rain, R-A-I-N. Amen. Hallelujah. Of your love. I feel the winds of your spirit. Now the heartbeat of heaven, let us hear. I feel the reins of your love. I feel the reins of your spirit. Now the heartbeat of heaven, let us hear. One more time, I feel the reins. I feel the reins of your love. I feel the winds of your spirit. Now the heartbeat of heaven, let us hear. I feel the reins. I feel the reins of your love. I feel the winds of your spirit. Now the heartbeat of heaven, let us hear. Let it rain. Let it Danny, what were you singing there? So go ahead and sing it out. Reins of your love. Feel the winds of your spirit. Now the heartbeat of heaven, let us hear. I feel the reins of your love. I feel the winds of your spirit. Now the heartbeat of heaven, let us hear. Extended family, over our workplace, over our city, over our community, over our schools, let it rain.
Amen. still see your face. What you spoke in, pouring your words of grace. Well, I will walk by faith, even when I cannot see.
Brother Chad, come on up.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
First let us pray. Father God, we just want to thank you, Lord God. We come to you humbling ourselves today, Lord God. We just thank you for your mercy, Lord God. We thank you for the breath in our lungs today, Lord God. We thank you that we made it through, Lord God, that you made a will and a way for us, Father God. We thank you that the things we went through, Lord God, prepared us for this day, Lord. I just praise your holy name today, Lord God.
Yes.
Father, I just praise your holy name today, Lord.
Yes.
God. I just thank you for your holiness, Lord God.
Yes.
For your power, Lord God, over my life and the lives in this room, Lord God, and the lives watching online, Lord God.
Yes, Lord.
We just give you all praise, honor, and glory, Lord, in Jesus' mighty name.
Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yes and amen.
So today I want to speak to you a little bit about spiritual warfare. In my life, it's been a journey in my life. I've had a few things in my life happen that where I felt like I should have died, you know. Huh. But the Lord seen fit to save my life through those things, and I'm still standing today.
Glory.
Because of his power and because of his divine appointment for my life.
Hallelujah.
Is the only reason I'm alive.
Glory.
I had in 2017, December 19th, I had a car accident where I was on the other side of this war that I'm going to talk about today.
Amen.
I was on drugs. I was in the darkness, should I say. I was in the darkness. Amen. I wasn't in no light, had no understanding, had no common knowledge. I was in the darkness. I was on drugs. I was driving a car with no license. It was a fog advisory. I blew through the stop signs. A F-150 hit me. I was in a little small Toyota. Hit me, flipped the car, had me stuck in the dashboard, bleeding out the head, you know, in the ditch. And this is at 2:30, 3 o'clock in the morning on a backcountry road. And so I laid there bleeding for who knows how long, unconscious. The first responders came, got me out of the car. I remember I thought I was in a puddle of water when I came conscious, but happened to be I was in my own blood. I had bled so much blood out of my body that I almost died from it. Amen. And it happened to be a fog advisory that night. They couldn't fly me to the Savannah Hospital because I'm from a little small town, and they didn't have the doctors needed there to try and save me. So they were gonna have to take me to the Savannah Hospital, which it was a fog advisory. They couldn't fly me. So they rushed me there in the ambulance. By the grace of God, they just did get me there in the nick of time, cut the clothes off of my body with the scissors, staple my head shut. By the grace of God, I'm here today.
Amen. Amen. Praise God.
So the unseen battles of spiritual warfare. Today I want to talk to you about the unseen battles of spiritual warfare that we face every day. As a follower of Jesus, we are engaged in a constant struggle against the forces of darkness that seek to destroy us and separate us from God. These battles are not physical, but spiritual in nature, and they are just as real and just as dangerous as any physical conflict we face. The Apostle Paul tells us in Ephesians 6:12 that our struggle is not against flesh and blood, but against the rulers, against the authorities, and against the powers of this dark world, and against the spiritual forces of evil in the heavenly realms. This verse reminds us that our true enemies are not other people, but the spiritual forces that seek to undermine our faith and lead us away from God.
Yes.
These unseen battles of spiritual warfare can take many forms. They may come in the form of doubt and confusion, causing us to question our beliefs and our relationship with God. They may come in the form of temptation, leading us to sin and stray from the path that God has set before us. They may come in the form of fear and anxiety, causing us to doubt not only ourselves, but God's love and provision for us. But no matter what form the battles take, we can take comfort knowing that we do not fight alone.
Hallelujah.
God is with us every step of the way, and He has equipped us with the armor we need to stand firm against the attacks of the enemy.
Yes.
Amen. In Ephesians 6:13 through 17, Paul described this armor as the belt of truth, the breastplate of righteousness, the shoes of peace, the shield of faith, the helmet of salvation, the sword of the Spirit, which is the Word of God.
Yeah.
With the armor, we can stand strong in the face of spiritual warfare. Amen.
Amen.
Knowing that God is fighting for us and that He has already won the victory.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
We must put and have it on at all times, every day.
That's right.
Through prayer, reading the Bible, and seeking fellowship with other believers.
That's right.
We must also be alert. What is an alarm? Alarm is something that lets you know there's sounds and when there's a problem.
Come on.
So recognizing signs of spiritual attacks and taking action to resist the enemy. Amen. Since when my feet hit the floor in the morning times, I should be taking an offense against him already. As soon as my feet hit the floor, I'm going against the enemy, because I know it's about when I said, okay, I'm gonna follow Jesus. When I chose that day, when I chose to follow Jesus, I knew there was a battle.
Yes.
Amen. I knew there was a battle. I was gonna have to fight it every day. It wasn't a big situation for me. I just knew it inside of my heart. I knew it. Because if you want to go, okay, only ones that I know that don't believe in God, the enemy's already got them.
That's right.
But most importantly, we must remember that our ultimate victory is not our own strength, but in the power of God.
Amen.
As it says in 1 John 4:4, greater is He that is in you. and me than he that is in the world. Yes. Amen. With God on our side, we can overcome any obstacle, defeat any enemy, and emerge victorious. Like I said, I was dead. I bled so much blood out of my body that I wasn't supposed to make. Like I said, it was a spiritual war. God had a plan, and the enemy had a plan. God, he let me live for this moment right here so I can tell someone else, hey, man, I was dead. I was dead to the world. I was dead to the world. I was dead to the darkness. I was dead to the drugs, to the lust, to the filth, to the guilt, condemnation, every single thing. Because when I was 13 years old, I had an experience with the Lord, and I spoke in another language I never knew. Okay, the Lord put his heart inside of me at a young age. And I ran like Jonah, okay? Amen. I ran from the Lord, and I ran from his calling, and I ran from his plans. But we all got a purpose, plan, in place. Amen. In the house of the Lord. Amen.
Amen. Come on. Amen. Got some dents in your arms now, baby.
Yes. Okay. So let us take up our armor, stand firm in our faith, and trust in the power of God to see us through. Let us not be afraid of the battle we face, but instead rejoice in the knowledge that we are more than conquerors. Hallelujah. Through him who loves us.
Amen, brother. Amen.
And let us go forth with confidence, knowing that God is with us every step of the way. Yes. And that he will never leave nor forsake us.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. And he chose you. Hallelujah.
And you know, these are just some things that but for me, it's been a constant formula of seeking his face and seeking more of him every single day of my life. That's how I make it today.
Amen.
And I'm grateful to know that inside. And if I can just reach one person with that, you know, that's what I seek to do. You know, it's not no genie in a bottle type thing. It's just me on my knees type thing. And I'm seeking his face. I'm crying out to God. It's serious. Because before I leave the house, I can die any time of the day. But when I die, I know where I'm going today. Because I got my soul in check with the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I'm not saying everything's easy and I go about. I'm not saying everything's okay. I face things, okay? But when we face things, we also face things with his power, with his will coming from heaven. Okay, when we activate the will of the Father from heaven onto earth and we start to walk in that will, then we're doing something.
Hallelujah.
But when we're stagnant in our ways, and oh man, I'm stuck again. Well, you're stuck again because you're not activated with the power and the anointing of the Father.
Come on. See you. Hallelujah.
The authority is like a car. It's like a traffic cop directing traffic at a busy intersection. It's like the authority that we have in the Lord God Almighty, who sent his only son down to die on the cross and shed blood for our sins. I give him all praise, honor, and glory for my breath in my lungs right now. And there's nothing I could do. Without him, I am nothing. I'm filthy without him.
Hallelujah.
And I'm just grateful today that I can be used by him and just whatever he would have me say, do, go, and I'm going to go. It's just that simple. It doesn't matter. I'm not here to be on a platform or none of that. Everyone that knows my heart, they knows I've been through some stuff, because I'm going to tell them when we talk. I'm going to tell them what I've been through so I can reach someone else with my testimony. Amen. That's how we get saved. That's how we stay saved.
That's right.
That's how we stay anointed.
Hallelujah.
And full of the Holy Spirit. So I'm just grateful. But it's just like I was going to say, it's like a traffic cop. You know, you got these, he's stopping traffic this way, he's stopping traffic that way. He's letting them go this way, that way. But there's two big trucks on this side. Does that traffic cop power stop them trucks? No, his authority with what he's got on stops them trucks. Because them trucks, they'll run him over. Amen. But the authority that he represents stops that traffic. That's the authority that I want to walk in every day.
Amen.
With the Lord.
Amen.
So we got to stay prayed up, people. Brothers and sisters. The nature of this battle is a spiritual battle. Satan's goal is to get a hold of our soul. That is his main goal, is to get a hold of our soul. He will hit us in our body, in our emotions, or personal relationships with God is what he's after. He cannot separate us from God, though. The Spirit of the Lord is what he can't separate us from. So I'm just here to tell somebody today, if you're going through a warfare with it, find some people to get into war with you, okay? Get in the boat with you. Help you walk this thing out, because you can't do it alone. You can't do it alone. And I got some scripture.
That's good, I like that.
That battle's in your mind.
Ephesians 6:11-13, put on the whole armor of God that you may be able to stand against the schemes of the devil, for we do not fight against flesh and blood, but against the rulers, against the authorities, against the cosmic powers over this present darkness, against the spiritual forces of evil in the heavenly places. Therefore, take up the whole armor of God that you may be able to withstand the evil day, and having done all, to stand firm. Amen. 2 Corinthians chapter 10, 3-5. For though we walk in the flesh, we are not waging war according to the flesh. For the weapons of our warfare are not of the flesh, but have divine power to destroy strongholds. We destroy arguments and every lofty opinion raised against the knowledge of God.
Hallelujah.
Is that what we're doing?
Hallelujah.
It's a war going on. Is that what we're doing? We should be.
Yeah, that's right.
And take every thought captive. Amen.
Ooh, come on.
That's what we're doing. Amen.
Come on with it. Come on with it.
James chapter 4, verse 7. Submit yourselves therefore to God. Resist the devil and he will flee from you.
Hallelujah. Preach.
That's some good news.
Preach.
1 Peter 5:8. Be sober-minded, be watchful. Your adversary, the devil, prowls around like a lion seeking who he may devour. Amen.
Amen.
Some good news for somebody.
Amen. Come on with it.
That tells me right there, I got to stay sober-minded, watchful, vigilant, to keep out. Keep a check. My house is covered in oil. We got that anointing in my house. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
That spirit, hallelujah.
Psalm 91.
Come on.
He who dwells in the shelter of the Most High will abide in the shadow of the Almighty.
Hallelujah.
I will say to the Lord, my refuge and my fortress, my God in whom I trust, for he will deliver you from the snare of the fowler and from the deadly pestilence. He will cover you with his pinions, and under his wings you will find refuge.
Hallelujah.
His faithfulness is a shield and buckler.
Hallelujah.
You will not fear the terror of the night,
hallelujah,
nor the arrows that flies by day.
In the name of Jesus. Come on.
Luke 10:19. Behold, I have given you authority to tread on serpents and scorpions and over all the power of the enemy, and nothing shall hurt you. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Deuteronomy 28:7. The Lord will cause your enemies to rise against you, to be defeated before you. That's some good news.
Hallelujah.
That's some good news.
Hallelujah.
They shall come against you one way and flee from you seven.
Hallelujah.
Come on. Jesus.
Hallelujah.
That's good news.
Come on. Preach.
That's some good news, brother.
Preach. Hallelujah.
Yeah, that's some good news.
Amen. Amen.
All right, here we go, y'all. I got a prayer, and I'm going to close with this prayer here. I just wanted to share a little bit of my story with everybody today. It is what it is. Strengthen my faith, Lord God. Forgive my sins so that I may be clean in your righteousness.
Yes.
Make me brave. so I can stand to fight the spiritual battles in my life and in our world, Lord God. Give me your wisdom and discernment so I won't be caught off guard, Lord God. Together, Lord, we'll win because in truth, you already have.
Amen. Hallelujah.
While evil still roams, the power of the name and your blood rises up to defeat, bring us victory against every evil plan against us. Actions may disturb us. We use the armor of God you have given us to stand firm. You will bring justice in due time for all the harm and needless violence aimed at your children. Until then, we remain in your presence, aligned with your purposes. And we look to you as our supreme commander and protector, Lord God. Help us to avoid temptation and deliver us from evil, Lord God. You are the mighty one, the one who ultimately bring all evil to light. With you, Jesus, we are safe. Amen.
Hallelujah.
God bless y'all.
Hallelujah.
Love you, brother.
Man, that was good. I want to expound on a couple things there. We brought up some good stuff, and then we're going to take communion. Also, does anybody, we got some vehicle magnets if anybody wants any. Anyone want one?
Oh, yeah.
Vehicle.
I've got an aluminum duty.
What?
I
think it might stick. I don't know. If you want one, they're up for grabs.
You got a refrigerator, though.
You already got one.
He'll support her all the way around his car.
He said extra. Also, does anybody need a war oil that doesn't have one already, the anointing oil that we made? You already have one. I gave
you. What do you think? I've been holding on to
him. Okay. Hey, man, that's good stuff. Hey, that's good stuff.
Chad, did y'all get some?
Yeah, I still got some.
Okay. You got some, Mish, right? Kelly, did you get an anointing oil?
Got some, yeah.
Hey, do I have to return the old bottle so you can
Yes.
For real?
The bottles are, yeah.
Here's the old one.
You got the old one? I'll fill it back up.
Hey, there you go.
Yeah, that's what I'm talking about.
This is the same one.
It's good stuff.
No, it's not.
It's filled.
But ain't nothing coming out of it.
Supernatural.
You gotta shake it.
It got supernaturally filled just now. Praise the Lord. I promise you, this thing is full. All right.
Fill my cup, Lord.
Fill my vial, Lord. All right, so good. I love the analogy of the cop. You know, a lot of people don't realize this, but the devil has power. You know, we're not glorifying him by any means. But he does have authority when we give it to him. That's the only time he has any authority. How did he get authority to begin with?
Deceiving.
Seeing.
We believe the lie.
Through Adam and Eve. Just like Matt said. Through Adam and Eve. We gave him the title deed to the earth. We gave him the title deed to the whole earth. So whenever the devil comes, as Sarah just said, and lies to us, we either believe the truth or we believe the lie. You know, there's coming such a time, I preached on deception last week, there's coming such a time where the deception is going to be so rampant that people are going to hear the devil and think it's the Lord. You got to know the voice of the Lord, the Good Shepherd. And the voice of a stranger, we are all capable of hearing, but we will not listen to. We won't hearken to if you're King Jamesy. Got an amen from Zach. Hallelujah. Did you have something out, or are you just praising the Lord? I'm just praising the Lord. You leave me be. Hallelujah. Also, the authority. The authority that we're in.
It's all right, brother.
He's the prince of the power of the air, but, you know, we have authority over that. So,
come on,
where does
God.
The devil operate out of? The first, second, or third heaven?
Second.
Second heaven. What does that mean? What's the second heaven, Zach?
Not the third heaven.
So, second heaven is the realm that we can't see in all the time. but we are a two-part or three-part being, but we both are in the spirit and out of the spirit at the same time. Where it's a bit of an anomaly. Kind of like a frog is a hybrid. You know, they can breathe underwater, they can breathe on land. C.S. Lewis compared us to a frog, and we can be in the spirit and not and in the physical at the same time. We are kind of an interdimensional as far as that goes. Now, the devil operates, his kingdom operates in the spirit realm, which is the second heaven. And this is Bible, too, because the Bible talks about a third heaven. So you just hit the button once, Jeff, until this blue light goes on. So when Daniel prayed to the Lord, y'all with me? When Daniel prayed to the Lord, when did he get his answer? But it was some stoppage, wasn't there? Some blockage 21 days later. He had set it as a mission to fast until he heard a word from the Lord. You could say he didn't really need to fast at all because the message, the word was sent forth that very same day because of his intention to fast, I believe. It expedited the word. However, what happened? Why was the word held back till the 21st day? Prince of Persia. So we're at war. We're at war. The Prince of Persia, a demonic entity, a high-ranking demonic entity that was over Persia, blocked. Who was it? Is it Michael or Gabriel?
Michael
had to fight him, and Gabriel. So Michael's an archangel, so high-ranking. Had to fight. They're both archangels, but he had to call for backup. Yeah. Hear me out. So many. This is against the Lone Rangers out there. They're trying to do things by themselves. We need each other. How do you fight the good fight of faith? And there's people out there that are not wanting to intermingle with other believers, or put yourself in a lukewarm church where they don't even recognize spiritual warfare. They think spiritual warfare is laying hands on people and saying, God, if it be your will, heal this person. That's not even Bible. It's not even biblical. That is a lack of faith prayer, and they call it humility. It's false humility. It's false humility. But they say that if you pray that they're healed, you're in pride, but it's really they're the ones in pride because they're falsely humble. Do you understand? Because the Bible says, by Jesus' stripes, you are healed. So that's the prayer of faith. And he said, when you go forth and lay hands on the sick, and they might be healed. They will be healed. So if I lay hands on Danny and say he's healed, that healing is in God's timing. However, it also has to do with that person's level of faith, is their receptivity to that prayer. If you don't receive the person praying for you as a man or woman of God, you're not going to receive. You're not going to receive. So praise the Lord. Amen. So when we pray, know we have something that Daniel didn't. We have access to the throne of grace that Jesus made. It didn't happen in Daniel's day. So we don't fight from a first heaven. People think that we do, but we fight from a third heaven perspective. Hallelujah. We can rain fire down. Hallelujah. 3 beats 2 in math. So if you pray from the throne of grace and rain fire down onto the devil, he has to flee. That's the submit to God in the third heaven. And then 3 is a greater number than 2, right? We're not geniuses here. But 3 is a greater number than 2. We fight from that place. Because if we fight from the place of the first, we don't recognize the authority that's been given to us by Christ.
Yeah, come on.
So when we fight from that place where we're in Jesus, and Jesus is in us, and we don't take off that armor, and we walk in that place of authority, we also have power. We have dunamis, explosive power. And we can rain fire down on the enemy. Sometimes the devil doesn't listen. You can be a traffic cop, but there's sometimes you got to pull out that pistol. And you got to pistol whip the devil. You got to tell him who's, you know, get back in your place. The only way the devil has any power to do anything over your life is because you have allowed it. People don't even know about the book of Job. What he feared most came to pass. It says that in the book, but people overlook it all the time. You have fear, you have an open door.
That's good.
Wow, amen.
What you fear most, what you're anxious about the most, it will happen because you have authority. If you are speaking in doubt and fear and unbelief, you're going to get fear. You're going to get doubt. You're going to get unbelief. But if you speak from a place of faith and it lines up with God's will, if it be thy will, get rid of that prayer. We have his will. We have his testament. It's written in paper. It's written in blood. It's written in red letters. We know his will because he gave it to us. And he said, here it is. Recognize it. We're either healed or we're sick. Which is truth? Which is the lie?
Healed.
We're either walking in power or we're walking in doubt.
Come on, that's right. Power. Come on.
Choose. We have a choice every single day. That's dying to ourselves, picking up our cross and dying to ourselves daily. And when we go out and we pray for people, we pray believing in faith they're going to be healed. What if they're not healed? What if I get embarrassed? It's not you doing the healing anyway. What are you embarrassed about? What's there to be embarrassed about? But you still pray in faith that they're healed. We were...
And it won't come, it won't return.
Sarah, come up here and testify.
It won't return, boy.
I got a scripture in my heart. Can't
yeah, come on. And then, no, we don't do scriptures here. Come on.
Okay, so I've been in James 5 the last few days. It's James 5, verse 14 through 15. And it says, is anyone among you sick? The elders, not the people that are 70 in their 80s, because religious people be like, oh, you only got a room full of 20s and 30s, they can't pray. No, it says elders, which is the spiritual leaders of the church. They're the sick person is to come up, they're to anoint him with oil, which is representing the Holy Spirit, and they will be healed. The prayer over faith will restore him up, and if he has sins, they will be forgiven.
Amen.
That's what we're to stand on.
Amen.
We will be forgiven.
Amen.
Because that,
Amen.
I don't remember what happened on Saturday, but that scripture was just bubbling.
Well, good.
Okay.
Have a seat. Mish, come up here. Talk a little bit about yesterday, some of our evangelism. And then don't let me forget, we got bags to hand out to everybody. So blessing bags, go bless somebody.
Hi, I'm Mish. What we saw yesterday, there was a man that I ran into that really spoke more than anything. Just like how we were at the Walmart, and Leo, you know, had it in his heart to talk to a man, and you know, I was still like unsure like who we'd reach out to, and lo and behold, he was a Christian. He's a faithful follower of Jesus, and just seeing him at his age and you know the experience he has in the church was so like. It was honestly overwhelming. Just like just something to look up to. Like, hey, that's where I want to strive to. Like in the race, in the work that I do for the Lord, let me be there. But still, even then, he was encouraging for us now, and it was definitely like, it was amazing. Like I've been doing the Saturday evangelism for the past like 6 months now, and I'm just like, you know, what was I doing before for Christ? Like how was I calling myself a Christian without, you know, spreading that to others? The good news, it's so good. It's like, why not tell other people?
Yeah.
And it's just something that I was scared of or just kind of hiding in the shadows of a Baptist church. And definitely not something that I took to heart for myself. Like, this is that important to me. This is that serious that I have to speak about it. Open my mouth.
Amen. But, amen.
Yeah.
Thanks, brother. Leo. Talk a little bit about yesterday, please.
Yeah, so we had a great time, and we went to Walmart together, four of us, just evangelizing, and we beforehand we prayed and we got some direction, and Jeremy gave some direction as well about where we're supposed to go. But this is the type of thing where we want to just be Spirit-led. And that means that as we, Brother Jeremy, he gave a lot of prophetic words that were very accurate. like that were like real specific too, you know. And when somebody tells you when you were 6 years old you had a trauma and the Lord is healing you from that right now, something along those lines, you know, and you really did have a trauma when you were 6 years old, it's going to touch your heart.
Yeah.
And it's going to really impact your life. And I've spent a lot of times with Brother Jeremy, you know, a lot of people are also growing into that gift, because it is something that you can grow into. Prophetic gift is one that, you know, even people who aren't normally prophets can become prophets, like as in Saul, the king, who he's not a prophet, but he joined the prophetic group and what they talked about him. So we're all working as together in praying the Lord would lead us to people, and he did, and that the Lord would give us specific words for people, and he did. Praise God. And that, you know, we would see and be encouraged through our experience. And that was the fact. The Lord led Mishael and I to somebody who really encouraged us by his faith. And we that was something that we both needed at that time. So it's a really good time to come out. I encourage anybody who feels led to come out as well.
Amen. Yeah, we a couple of the people we prayed for were really highlighted to me. One guy in Walmart ran away from me. Yeah. The Lord gave me a word for him, and he was like, I don't want anything to do with you. but just being real, because that'll happen sometimes, but it's not discouraging. It's
Omar, yeah.
Yeah.
Omar,
yeah. The guy before that, though, we prayed for this one guy. Me and Sarah prayed for this one guy, and he started like shaking in the middle. We were like in the Dollar Tree later, and then he was shaking, and he was like, "Whoa!" He about fell out in the Dollar Tree. It was pretty awesome. He was like, "Look at this! Look at my legs!" And his legs were twitching, and he had hobbled into the store. So I believe he was getting some healing. So it was pretty awesome. Yeah, he actually had a pretty neat testimony. He was like, I'm a preacher, I preached until I ran out of money, and then I ran from the calling and all this stuff, and the Lord was showing me he still evangelizes and stuff. And what was the lady's name? Omar and Iris. Iris, we prayed for this couple right as we were leaving, and that was probably the most powerful thing. Right as he walked up, he was like, the guy was like, I'm not an apostle. I forgot how that came out. And I was like, no, you're not an apostle, but you're, and I had a word for him. And he was like, how do you know that? It was pretty awesome. I don't even remember what I said. Do y'all remember what I said?
Even if he's an evangelist and
he was shy growing up and he's completely different than the way he used to be. And his mom was right there. His mom was Iris. And she was like, he was shy as a kid and he's not that way no more. So it's pretty awesome. Yeah, he was crying and he walked away like just talking to the Lord. He was like, wow. That was pretty awesome. So, man, just an awesome time. We do that 3:30 on most Saturdays, and we, you know, sometimes we'll go put up the little tent and pray for people, and sometimes this past time we kind of do like a treasure hunt thing. You know, it's whatever the Lord leads us to do, you know. We don't want to become, like, monotonous in what we're doing, the same thing over and over. So we want to keep it interesting and spirit-led, absolutely. So I got a couple of prayer requests that came in. Brother Anthony Hawkins said, pray for me and my wife and our ministry. So if y'all could. So, Father God, we thank you for Brother Anthony. God, we thank you. We lift his ministry up to you, Lord God, and his family, Lord God. God, we thank you that he's keeping the first thing first. I don't know if he's still watching right now, Lord. We got a bunch of people tuning in. But Father God, we thank you that you're just touching their relationship, that they're growing in you, that they're putting you first in your kingdom and your righteousness and your glory, Lord. And God, we know when we do that, all else falls into place. All else will be granted to us. Your word promises us such. So Father God, we thank you. God, we thank you for deeper intimacy. God, we thank you for greater encounters. God, we thank you that they're writing the vision, making it plain on tablets and running with it, Lord. So, Father God, thank you for that. God, thank you that they're being spirit-led. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. We got a bunch of people, if you need prayer, comment before we sign off here. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. And all the comments disappeared for me. There we go. He said, in this season, God looking for those ready to be about the Father's business. Amen. And operate in the prophetic office. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
I guess that's your mom on here. She said, great job, son.
All right.
Jenny Craft. That was an awesome word. Proud mama. Hallelujah. My mom's name is Jenny, too. Is that your mom? It's not spelled with a G, though. It's spelled with a J. Yeah. Two Jennies. Yeah. It's spelled like the English Jenny. Like a guinea. All right. Hallelujah. So, last call for prayer on here. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. All right. Let's close in a word of prayer. So, Father God, we thank you for teaching us greater works, for teaching us and giving us greater discernment for the days to come.
Yes, God.
Father God, we thank you for releasing, just as you did with Jabez, greater authority, greater power over the enemy and the works of the devil. Greater, for greater is he that is in us than he that is in the world. We are seated in high heavenly places in the third heaven with Christ Jesus our Lord, the Messiah. He is the Son of God, and he is God. It's an anomaly. We serve a triune God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit in us. Father God, help us to go out and be your representatives, to be your ambassadors on this earth while there is still time left. Father God, let us not look inwardly, but look outwardly. Father God, to see those that are in need, to have compassion for the lost, for he who wins souls is wise. Father God, we have treasures in heaven because you have appointed us and anointed us for every good work.
Yes,
God. And to trample, as Brother Chad said, to trample on the serpents, on the scorpions, and every snake. Every snake, every religious demon is under our feet. Every devil under our feet. Somebody needs to say that today with me. Devil, you are under my feet.
Under my feet.
Isn't it fun to remind him?
Yes.
Father God, we thank you for an impartation of joy. For the joy of the Lord is our strength.
Yes.
As for me and my house, we're going to laugh at the enemy. Every wicked scheme he cooks up is all going to come to naught. Because greater is he that is in me. And when he attacks me, when he attacks you, if you're in Christ and Christ is in you, he's attacking the living God, and he's gonna fail. He will fail, because he's a failure, and everything he tried to get you to come into agreement with over your life, he's prophesying over his own.
Yes, come on.
You're nothing but a loser. Thanks for reminding me you're a loser, devil.
Yeah.
You're nothing but a failure. Yeah, you fail every time you come against God.
Yes, come on.
Wow. You're rejected. Yeah, weren't you kicked out of heaven?
Yeah.
You're calling me rejected?
Yeah.
Trying to get me to come into agreement with you. That's funny right there. That's funny. He's a joke. He's got power, but only the authority that you give him.
That's right.
He was the anointed cherub that fell. God doesn't take away the gifts. He's still got power. However, he can't use it on you.
He's commanded.
When he pulls out a gun, it's going to go nothing but click, 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 because he's got nothing that can be used. No weapon formed against you shall prosper. He never said it wouldn't be formed. He said it wouldn't prosper.
Come on. Come on.
We witnessed the drug dealers that had guns, and they fell out in the spirit. People in our group freaking out they got a gun. Whatever. You see that guy on the ground? You're scared of the guy on the ground with his eyes rolling back in his head getting delivered. You're scared of that? We're gonna look on the devil one day and say, this worm, this is Bible, this worm, this is the one that laid the nations low? This is the one.
It's called fear.
Nothing. He's not a dragon anymore. No feet. Defeated. He's a snake. He's a worm.
Snake. Yeah.
He's a worm. Somebody needs to tell the devil, don't get the devil all mad. He's a worm.
You're a worm and bird eat.
He's a worm. Eagles eat worms.
Where's worms at?
When you mount up on the wings of eagles, you shall renew your strength. Those that wait on the Lord. Those that serve the Lord. Those that serve others for the Lord. They will mount up on wings like eagles. An eagle represents the office of the prophet.
Come on, it does.
We have access. Eagles can go to the throne of grace anytime the veil is torn. And we need to tell the devil what's up.
Amen.
When we are alerted, we're not alerted in fear. We're alerted from a place of, I know what you're up to, you lying worm, you devil. And then you command him.
Yeah.
You know, you can know what the devil's up to because you can hear that voice and you just prophesy pretty much the opposite of what he's saying all the time. It's not rocket science. They hate you, huh? They hated Jesus.
Yeah.
They think you're false. What are you doing this for? I'm not doing this for you, devil. Come on, somebody. Your healing is never gonna happen. It's the devil. It's the devil. It's the devil. I'm already healed.
Come on, come on.
Already healed. It is written. It says I'm healed.
Hallelujah.
Done deal.
Hallelujah.
Says I'm healed.
Amen.
I'm healed.
Healed.
By his stripes, the lacerations that were on his back from the cat of nine tails. He did that for your healing.
Yeah.
And a religious demon's gonna say, oh, he just did that for your spiritual healing. He did that for your physical healing.
Yeah.
Spirit, soul, and body. Hallelujah. Amen.
Go bless somebody with those bags.
Mm-hmm. Come on. Communion?
Papa gave you a brand new bag. Yeah, we're gonna do communion.
Partake.
Thank you, sir. Brother Leo, can you lead us in communion?
I invite you to take the communion elements and take and unwrap them. There's a top layer for the cracker, and there's a bottom layer for the... What was that?
Matt's trying for a double blessing.
Let me get a six pack.
All right, before we get dismiss, we're going to be taking communion, so let me get everybody to just focus for a moment on what we're doing here. And I'm going to pray over this communion, and then we're going to take it together. Okay? So, Heavenly Father, we thank you for providing the bread of heaven that we could partake of, that we all needed because we were lost.
Yes.
And you gave us the bread of heaven that we could partake of this bread and live forever. And so, Lord, we don't just look to survive in this world, but we're really looking to eternal life, which is so much more. So, Father, as we partake of this eternal life, who's Jesus himself, we partake of eternal life. Him, we partake of him together.
Yes.
In Jesus' name, let's partake.
Thank you, Lord.
And Lord, it's not anything that we could have done to deserve your blood.
Yes.
The precious price that was paid for our salvation, that was paid to break the back of the evil one, to break his authority over us, to break his ability, his sting. So, Lord, as we partake of the blood, we thank you for cleansing. Thank you for cleansing us, for washing over our soul, as I'm just repeating, Danny, for washing over us, making us spotless and without blemish. Amen. Amen. So as we partake, okay, fine. I won't hold this too long, but just there's one more thing. I believe that this is from the Lord. This blood is for you and for me. And
just not yet.
Okay, I'll stop there. This blood is for you. Remember that there's a song that says this blood is for you. Okay. Take it in together. Thank you. Yeah, go ahead and take it, Brother Danny.
Where did the trash thingy go?
I have 1 2-minute thing.
1 2-minute. Oh, you got it already. Thanks.
All right, enjoy the time of fellowship together.
Man, that's what it's fun to do. Right? I gotta laugh.
I want somebody. Well, let's all declare prophetically before we dismiss officially.
Yes, amen.
We're not surviving, but thriving.
We're not surviving.
Let's say that one more time. I'm not just surviving.
I'm not just surviving.
In Christ, I'm thriving.
In Christ, I'm thriving.
Once more. I like that. I'm not just surviving.
I'm not just surviving.
In Christ, I am thriving. Hallelujah. We are dismissed.
Feeling you.